The opening ceremonies kicked off this morning live right here on NBC2, of course, with no fans in the stands.
You can catch it all again if you missed
it
this morning.
It's an incredible experience, you know, just to do that.
The Parade of Nations right here on NBC2 starting at 7:30.
It's an incredible experience, you know, just to do that, represent your country.
If you're looking for someone to root for in addition to Team USA, we have you covered.
NBC2's Sean Baer reports on the two FGCU alums competing in the games this year.
With each passing Olympiad, FGCU is making it a habit of sending Eagles onto the Olympics, whether it be on the pitch or in the pool. A pair of Eagles are getting set to represent their countries and their school at the Olympics.
A dream come true for one.
In her mind, it's officially official.
And a dream continued for another.
It's an incredible experience, you know, just to do that, represent your country.
Over the next 2 weeks, FGCU will be represented by two Olympians in Tokyo, continuing a school tradition of sorts.
Well, it's such a strong tradition over the years that we've had Olympians come through FGCU. And it's an honor to be able to keep the tradition going.
As FGCU head swimming and diving coach Dave Rollins watches the opening ceremonies from his office, he will be nervously awaiting the next few days for one of his swimmers, Petra Halmai, to make her Olympic debut for Hungary.
As an athlete, I never got nervous, but as a coach, all the time. Just a lot of positive vibes and positive words heading her way.
Right down the hall from Rollins' office, head women's soccer coach Jim Blankenship will be glued to his screen as well, keeping up with former FGCU soccer player Julia Rodar on Team Sweden.
Julia was phenomenal when she was here, so for her to be able to continue and just have those experience, you know, it's almost like a proud father.
Blankenship especially proud after Rodar's squad pulled off the upset of the Olympics so far, shutting out the Americans in their opening match, ending USA's 44-game winning streak.
And she was just beaming, you know, obviously to get a result like that against the number one team in the world, you know, so they're on a pretty good high.
Now, if you want to keep up with these two Eagles greats, Rodar and Team Sweden take on Australia Saturday morning at 4:30 over in Tokyo. Halmai doesn't dive into the pool, by the way, for another 6 days. In Fort Myers, I'm Sean Barry for NBC2.